inauguration ceremony, Dr. Dean Sprinkle as the 7th president of Wytheville Community College. Please stand for the presentation of college by the representatives of Carroll County Junior ROTC and the Wythe County Junior ROTC Color Band. This will be followed with a Pledge of Allegiance and the National Anthem, performed by Ms. Cynthia Jackson, Director of the WCC Choir. I invite you to join me now in reciting the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Celebration of college and our commitment to honored to serve on the Presidential Selection Committee last year. There were many qualified people, and we spent a great deal of time and effort trying to make sure that we selected the best possible candidate for WCC. Dr. Sprinkle, from your interview with the statewide selection committee in Richmond to your interviews and presentation at the WCC campus, it quickly became clear to us that you were indeed the best qualified person to lead this institution forward. Since you became president, you have certainly proved to us that we made the right choice. You consistently demonstrate your commitment to the college's mission and to the unique role that community colleges play in higher education. You relate well with the students we serve, as well as other members of the WCC faculty, staff, and area residents. Dr. Sprinkle, on behalf of the entire college board, I would like to extend our sincere congratulations and best wishes for your presence. We look forward to working with you. At this time, I would like to ask Dr. Rhonda Captain Wood, Vice President of College Development, to come forward to make several.
Good afternoon. Thank you for attending today's ceremony. As we begin the program, I would like to introduce members of the platform party and ask that each to stand as he or she is introduced. Please hold your applause until each person is recognized. To my right, Mr. Roger Thompson, Chair of the WCC College Board, Dr. Lynn Dubois, Chancellor of the Virginia Community College System, and Dr. Dean Sprinkle, WCC President. To my left, Ms. Sherry Phillips, WCC Faculty Representative, Karen Alexander, WCC Support Staff Representative, and Matthew Wilson, WCC Student Representative. I would also like to recognize several dignitaries and special guests who have joined us today. First, we would like to acknowledge the members of the Wytheville Community College Board who are in attendance. Would all current College Board members please stand and be recognized? We would also like to recognize former members of the WCC College Board and current and former members of the WCC Educational Foundation Board and the WCC Scholarship Foundation Board. Would you please stand and be recognized? We are also pleased to have a member of the State Board for Community Colleges in our audience today, Mr. Robin Sullenberger. We would like to welcome representatives of our current legislators. Here with us today, Laura Blevins, Office of U.S. Senator Tim Kaine. Good stand. Jennifer Fendenson, Office of U.S. Congressman Morgan Griffith. And Mr. Stuart Higley, Office of U.S. Senator Bill Carrico. I'm not sure if anyone from Jeff Campbell's office. Okay. Thank you, Mr. We were expecting a former member, seeing Annie B. Crockett start, but we appreciated her service to the college as a legislator. We are extremely proud of the strong ties that WCC has with our local governments and with the public schools in our service region. Would representatives of local governing bodies, our area public schools, and area school boards please stand and be recognized? In addition to Chancellor Dubois, there is also another representative of the Virginia Community College System here with us today, Dr. Craig Herndon, Vice Chancellor of Workforce Development. As part of today's special ceremony, representatives from all public and private institutions of higher education in Virginia and nearby states were invited. We want to thank them for participating. Would the official delegates of all 2 and 4 year colleges and universities please stand and be recognized. Wytheville Community College faculty, staff, and administrators play a vital role in the day-to-day operations of the college and truly make it possible for us to serve students and our communities. Would all WCC faculty, staff, and administrators please stand and be recognized. We also want to recognize WCC students who are here with us today. In addition to Matthew Wilson, we have several student ushers who are assisting with today's ceremony. Please stand as I call your name, and audience, please hold your applause until all students are introduced. Stephanie Boucher, Sarah Caldwell, Aspen Cruz, Devin Hunt, Travis King, Leslie Johnson, Rachel Porter, and Savannah Sykes. Thank you. Many of you may have recognized a familiar face who honored us by leading today's academic procession, retired WCC President Dr. Charlie White. Charlie served this college very well from 2006 to 2015. He is joined today by his wife, Peggy. Would you please stand and be recognized. We are also honored that President Emeritus, Dr. William F. Snyder, is in attendance. He served as president of WCC from 1980 to 2000. Dr. Snyder, we are very pleased that you traveled from Richmond to participate in today's inauguration ceremony. Also, Dr. Edwin Barnes, president of WCC from 2005 to 2006, is here today. Dr. Barnes has had a long and distinguished career in the VCCS, having also served as president of New River Community College and Paula Camp Community College. Dr. Barnes, we want to welcome you and Shirley today. Wytheville Community College is fortunate to have many former faculty and staff members who helped establish a strong foundation for the college. We would like to recognize their tremendous contributions. Would the retirees and faculty emerita of WCC please stand. We extend a special welcome to the members of Dr. Sprinkle's family who are with us this afternoon. His wife, Jamie, stand. His son, John, and wife, Stephanie. His son Nicholson and Paige, his mother Chancey Sprinkle, his sister Joan Godfrey, sister-in-law Judy Harden Batts, as well as other extended family members. Thank you for coming. Wytheville Community College is proud of our outstanding faculty. Ms. Sherry Phillips, Program Head of Nursing, currently serves as president of the WCC Faculty Assembly. Sherry will bring greetings on behalf of the WCC faculty.
Good afternoon. My name is Sherry Phillips, and on behalf of the faculty of Wytheville Community College, I would also like to welcome everyone to this momentous occasion. In preparation for today, as a representative of this college's faculty, I began to reflect on my own past experience. experience in being a community college student and later becoming a part of the WCC faculty. After several years of service as an LPN, I decided to continue my RE education at Virginia Highlands Community College. I was working full-time at the hospital and part-time at the surgeon's office. I had young children, and I initially attended school at night to pursue my goal of becoming an RN. I was a first-generation student, and many times it was difficult managing everything. In spite of the challenges, I felt a connection with the educational institution, especially with the faculty. I will never forget having a brief conversation with a fellow student and showing her how to use a simple piece of hospital equipment. My nursing instructor came to me later and said, "Sherry, you should really consider going on to school and teaching." I was amazed at her statement, while at the same time thinking, if she only knew, becoming an instructor was my professional goal. With faculty encouragement, I kept attending classes. Sometimes it would have been easier to have quit rather than persevering. Yet when I felt overwhelmed, the faculty would always seem to know and express a kind word about my work or simply take the time to listen and give me the reassurance that I needed to pursue my nursing education. I graduated with my associate in the applied science degree, continued my education earning a bachelor's degree in nursing, and later earned a master's degree. Ultimately, I became a member of the WCC faculty, fulfilling my dream of being able to help community students just as I had been helped when I was a student. Why am I telling this story of presidential inauguration? I share my story because I think that it is a common story of what our students face, and a story of how our faculty and the entire college-wide community responds to the needs of our students. We have had the opportunity to work with Dr. Sprinkle for the past year. Dr. Sprinkle has a strong background in community college education. He understands the students that we serve. As president, he listens to our concerns and works with the faculty assembly to seek solutions to issues that we face as educators. He is also committed to providing professional development opportunities to give faculty the resources that we need to provide the best possible education for our students. Under his leadership, we are creating action plans to facilitate student success through initiatives such as advisor training, mentoring, quality enhancement plans, guided pathways, academic alert systems, and early interventions to help our students succeed. Ladies and gentlemen, this is what Wytheville Community College is all about. The faculty, administration, and staff working in collaboration to promote our students' success. In closing, on behalf of the faculty, I would like to again thank Dr. Sprinkle for not only choosing to be employed here, but for also choosing to lead us and work with us as Wytheville Community College moves forward as an institution to provide quality education and success for our students. Thank you.
Thank you, Sherry. The Wytheville Community College support staff is another group of people who are extremely important in helping the college fulfill its mission. Today, Ms. Karen Alexander, Registrar and President of the WCC Support Staff Assembly, will bring greetings on behalf of her colleagues.
On behalf of the support staff of Wytheville Community College, I thank you all for joining us in celebration of the inauguration of our 7th President, Dr. Dean Sprinkle. As a college dedicated to providing access to lifelong learning within an environment of academic excellence, we each have a unique yet closely intertwined role to play in achieving this mission. As you look around you and upon this stage, you'll see your leaders, your coworkers, faculty, and students, your fellow community members, your mentors, and your friends. Without any one of these, the college would fall short in achieving its mission. As support staff, we provide services that, in conjunction with others, lead Our titles and duties may be diverse, but our goals are the same. The footprint of the support staff can be seen throughout our guiding principles. To offer a comprehensive program of student development services. To serve as an important linkage between secondary education and four-year colleges and universities. To enrich local communities by making available resources in people, facilities, libraries, and programming. To ensure a helpful and safe environment on campus. To be fiscally responsible and accountable. To promote accessibility and affordability. And to ensure quality in all programs and services. Everything that we do is directed for making WCC accessible to learners, focused on student success, and of the highest academic quality. We excel in making our students' educational goals attainable, our co-workers' jobs just a bit easier, and our communities a bit brighter. Our successes are mirrored in the feeling of pride a high school student has as she transitions to her first year of college, in the hope a recently laid-off worker has in training for his new career, and in the look of accomplishment our graduates have in their eyes as they walk across this very stage every spring. Aristotle once said, "We are what we repeatedly do. Excellence, then, is not an act, but a habit." By maintaining the highest regard for student success in our every action, we move ever closer to this ideal. The Support Staff Assembly serves as the voice of the WCC support staff and as a liaison between WCC president, administration, and staff. The SSA supports two scholarship endowments that have raised over $19,000 since their creation. We partner with the Professional Development Committee and other groups on campus to assess support staff needs and communicate that information to the college president and administrators. These efforts have led to more sharing of information and more ways to recognize the dedication of WCC support staff members. We plan and organize appreciation events and participate in worthwhile community events such as the Relay for Life. In recent years, the WCC Support Staff Assembly has established a student food pantry on the Wytheville campus to complement the existing one at the Crossroads Institute in Galax, so that no student is hindered by hunger in his or her ability to excel academically. It is through the shared efforts of all WCC stakeholders that these projects have been and will continue to be a success. The WCC experience is shaped by every touch point a student encounters along his or her academic journey. All support staff members, regardless of their role, contribute to the shared success that we all feel as a part of the WCC family. Therefore, we welcome Dr. Springle to WCC as the leader of the next generation of this wonderful campus community, and as those around you will attest, family. In the words of Henry Ford, coming together is a beginning. Staying together is progress. Working together is success. Here's to a vibrant future for WCC as we all enthusiastically embrace the leadership of Dr. Springle and play our unique roles in leading Wytheville Community College to a new era of academic excellence. Thank you.
Thank you, Karen. The most important members of the WCC family are our students. We are honored today to have Matthew Wilson as a representative of our student body. Matthew is a second-year student in the pre-engineering program. He was recently selected as one of only 9 community college students in Virginia to participate in the prestigious Valley Proteins Fellowship Program, an honor made possible through the Virginia Foundation for Community College Education. Please welcome Matthew Wilson, who will bring greetings from the students at WCC.
Good afternoon. I'm so honored to be a part of such a big day for Dr. Dean Sprinkle at Wytheville Community College, as well as the surrounding communities that WCC so proudly serves. Today we recognize a new chapter for the college, and I know that it's going in my second year here working toward an Associate's in Science with specialization in engineering. And I already cannot thank the college enough for the opportunities it has provided to me and other students. I graduated from Gaylights High School in 2015, and I had always really enjoyed school. However, I had no clue what I wanted to do next. When I was in school, my mother had my little sister Shannon breaking my 13-year run as an only child. When Shannon was born, Mom became a stay-at-home mom, and in those few years, she decided that she wanted better for our family. So the year that Shannon started pre-K, Mom went back to college, or began college for the first time, actually becoming the first person in our immediate family to do so. And after being out of school for 20 years, this was a difficult adjustment, but she did it. In the semester that I graduated from Gaylights, she graduated from WCC. After witnessing her experience here, I knew I wanted to follow her and begin my higher education at Wytheville as well. But even then, I had no clue of the life-changing experiences and opportunities that were about to unfold before me. As a student here, it is easy to see just how devoted WCC is to providing the highest possible quality education to its students. This extends to the dedicated faculty and staff, and certainly to Dr. Sprinkle, who has already made evidence to me and many others that his number one focus is the overall bettering of the college, including the faculty and students. And isn't that what it's truly all about? The WCC mission statement, which is located in your programs today, reads, Wytheville Community College is committed to providing lifelong learning and an environment of academic excellence. And there are several guiding principles to ensure that this mission is executed. All of these are wonderful and inspiring, but there is one that really stands out to me above the rest. It says, to take a leadership role and help you shape the future direction of our communities. Ben Franklin once said, an investment in knowledge pays the best interest. The very same can be said of the communities, businesses, and individuals who assist the college in investing in each student who attends WCC. With the technical programs continuing to grow, there is an increasing opportunity for a relatively quick turnaround and benefit for the area. The transfer programs WCC offers are also growing and becoming more successful in creating long-term investments in students who decide to return to the service region. So I believe Wytheville had it right when it said it must take a leadership role in helping forge the future of this region. This is an enormous responsibility and an equally important task. This is likely the area that our families will grow in, our children will settle around, and generations after us will inhabit. While we can never afford to forget our roots, who's to say that our communities are the farthest outreach we have in terms of change? All it takes is one individual to change the world. Some of the greatest movements in history were began and ultimately headed by a single individual. Education is the most powerful weapon we have to change the world. A short but incredibly powerful quote by Nelson Mandela, and I strongly believe this to be true. With education becoming continually larger and groups of people that it touches through the community college system, who's to say that the next one to lead a societal change cannot come from right here at WCC? Open-mindedness, perspective, and confidence are three major keys to any form of change. These factors, as well as many others, are a direct output of quality education. So as we are here today to celebrate a new chapter for Wytheville Community College and Dr. Dean Sprinkle, we must not forget that we each, as students, as faculty and staff, or as a community, must take a leadership role ourselves in helping WCC to shape the future. So on behalf of all the students of WCC, Dr. Sprinkle, we are incredibly thankful and excited to have such a deserving individual stepping into such a large role for the college. We know that WCC is in good hands and will continue to grow as it has through years of memorable guidance, some new levels of success for students of the area. And again, thank you all for being a part of that with us today.
Thank you, Matthew. We wish you and your fellow students much success in your studies and future endeavors. It is now my pleasure to welcome Dr. Glenn Dubois, Chancellor of the Virginia Community College System. Dr. Dubois became Chancellor in 2001 in In that position, he acts as chief executive officer of a 23-college, 40-campus system of comprehensive community colleges located throughout the Commonwealth of Virginia. He previously held the position of commissioner and CEO of the New Hampshire Community Technical College System and was director of community colleges for the State University of New York. Please join me in welcoming Dr. Dubois, who will lead the ceremony for the investiture of Dr. Dean Sprinkle.
Well, thank you, friends. You know, Matt, listening to you, I think I'm here to inaugurate the second coming. That was terrific. But really, though, today offers us a chance to celebrate this institution, this college, the mission that we share, and the new president that's leading the way. So I have some brief, formal responsibilities in today's ceremony. I know the deal. You don't go to a wedding to see the minister. You don't come to inauguration to listen to a chancellor. And every moment we speak on stage is just another moment getting us away from a real celebration. As much as I'm here to sing the praises of Dean, I'm also here to say thanks to the wonderful faculty and staff of this institution. You know, we created our 23 community college system half a century ago. This is our 50th anniversary. We created them to do what no one else would do, to address the unmet needs in higher education and workforce education. In short, to give everyone, and I mean everyone, a shot at the American dream. Our mission is both urgent and timeless. Typically, those who choose to make this their life's work do so with an uncommon passion and an unyielding persistence. Today, however, offers us a brief pause in that pursuit. An inauguration offers us the chance to catch our breath for once and to celebrate our work. Today, we revel in the formal installation of a new president, Dean. Now, we don't play favorites when it comes time to select a new president. In fact, that process begins here in this community with meetings focused on the future of this college. And we ask this college to address certain questions. Who are we? Where are we going? What will be our priorities? The answers become the foundation of our search for your college's next president. What was a national search with nearly 100 candidates gets whittled down to a handful of finalists. They visit the college where the community gets a good chance to size them up, to kind of kick the tires, so to speak. Dean Sprinkle is part of the mass migration we've witnessed this decade of whip smart higher education leaders leaving behind North Carolina. The promised land that we call the Commonwealth of Virginia. And we couldn't be more happier to benefit from that mass migration. As many of you know, Dean is a low-key man with a big heart and a commitment to what he calls the service model of leadership. Wytheville Community College was a very fine college in a great position when Dean first assumed this job. That's not to say there weren't challenges. Generational shift, a round of retirements meant that he had to build a team of senior leaders pretty much from scratch, right from the beginning. And oh yeah, he had to navigate the college through a process called reaccreditation. Happens every 10 years. It's a big deal. And I suppose for fun, just to top up the difficulty level, we could have made him wear a blindfold while he was doing it, walking around campus with his hands tied behind his back. But Dean very quickly validated the decision to hire him by getting that leadership team in place, earning the college's reaccreditation without any findings, and further earning the description of being a great college to work for. And Dean did it all with a smile. Now, I understand that Dean, get this, Charlie, Bill, Ed. Dean is the first president in the college's history to own a smartphone. And faculty and staff are still adjusting to the shock of being able to send and receive text messages with the college president. Hey, get this, Charlie, get Bill. I understand that he's a rather formidable Pokemon Go player. But Charlie doesn't know what I'm talking about. But for those of you who are competing against him in Pokemon Go, you should probably know that he's cheating. You see, the presidents have to come to Richmond for meetings about every other month. And Dean has confided in people that he loves those trips. Here's the reason why. It's not to see me. It's because it allows him to capture different Pokemon creatures that he can't find around with him.
Is that okay to say that?
But here's something else about Dean. His compassion extends to animals. He's a big-time animal lover. And that conviction extends to every part of his life, from his commitment to a vegan diet, to caring for the pet bear that has seemingly taken up residence in his backyard in the spring. I've always found people who live, not just talk about, but live their values like Dean Sprinkle, they end up really being some of the best role models for the students that we serve. In fact, Dean and his lovely wife, Janie, quickly have become popular throughout this community, building great connections with the college's students, various businesses, and donors who are vital to this mission. As one college employee said to me recently, you never really have to worry about Dean speaking off script because he's never off message. It's a quick study, and his enthusiasm for what's happening on campus is contagious, and it's winning people over left and right, day after day. Well, Dean, you're winning me over too. I have playfully said to Dean from time to time that as a new president, he was still on probation. I'm not sure that he knew I was kidding. So let me declare for the record, with all of you as my witness, that today, on this day of inauguration, Dr. Dean Sprinkle is no longer on probation at Wytheville Community College. So Dean, it is a pleasure to fulfill my formal part of the program and pass along to you some traditions and symbols of the college office, the office of the president. We honor the long-standing traditions of these inaugurations by wearing our academic regalia, as you can see, and entrusting you with two symbols of leadership, the gavel, which I have here, and the medallion, which I'll put on you momentarily. While I'm proud to continue that tradition with you, Dean, those are not the symbols I would personally select to pass along. You know, if you're like me, you have plenty of them in your office already. Instead, I'd like to pass along to you a blank journal, one that doesn't even have lines on the pages. Those other items are about honoring the past. The journal, instead, is a reminder that the success story of your time here as president remains largely unwritten and without limits. Working with your team, with your faculty, with your community and staff, that story will take form and grow the way you collectively see it and the way you collectively lead it. So make that story a real good one. And now, by the authority vested in me as chancellor by the State Board for Community Colleges. I'm delighted to install you, Dr. Dean Sprinkle, as the 7th President of Wytheville Community College. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in formally welcoming President Dean Sprinkle.
First, let me thank those who are responsible for organizing today's event. And if you will, please stand as I call your name. Danita Burnett, my executive assistant. Plus, the same to Ray Barlow. Jerry Montgomery, the administrative assistant. Dr. Rhonda Captain Wood. And there are a number of other folks who Danita has recruited to make this event special, but we do want to thank them all, and it's special to this. Now let me begin by expressing a heartfelt thank you to all of our speakers for their kind words, and again, Chancellor, BCCS staff, dignitaries, including our university and college delegates, faculty, staff, board members, and guests. Modifying a slogan for the town of Wytheville, I would like to extend you a warm welcome to Wytheville Community College, a place which proudly serves this portion of Southwest Virginia, including Land County, Carroll County, Grayson County, Wythe County, the City of Galax, and a portion of Smith County. This region of the Commonwealth of Virginia has certainly extended a warm welcome to me and Jamie. While we're here today to recognize the transition for our college, more importantly, it is a day to recognize and celebrate Wytheville Community College. WCC is truly a special place that is accomplishing great things for the community it serves. For example, WCC consistently has one of the highest completion rates of all Virginia's community colleges. For the 2016 fiscal year, we were 5th overall in awarding workforce credentials among the Virginia community colleges. According to the Department of Education, WCC is 20th most affordable of all community colleges in the country. And this past year, as Chancellor DuBois referenced, WCC was recognized by the Chronicle of Higher Education as one of the great colleges to work for. These accomplishments are a direct result of the faculty, staff, and community that make up WCC. A large part of what makes us special is the level of community support that we enjoy. One such example being the Wythe Land Foundation. Through this foundation, whether pursuing a technical or transfer program, high school graduates of Wythe and Bland counties are eligible for scholarships to attend WCC, tuition free. Additionally, the WCC Forging Future Scholarship Program, funded by the Virginia Tobacco Commission, provides scholarships to qualified students throughout our service region. We're also fortunate to have generous alumni and donors who assist our students in making their dreams a reality. Whether they attend classes on the Wytheville campus, at the Crossroads Center in Galax, at the Summit Center in Marion, or as dual enrollment students in their high school or online. And in addition, we have an incredible leadership team who I'd like to take just a moment to acknowledge. Members of the cabinet, please stand and remain standing as I call your names. Dr. Lori Hubbard, Vice President of Instruction and Student Services. Dr. Rhonda Catherine Wood, Vice President of College Development. Ms. Crystal Krieger, Vice President of Finance and Administrative Services. Mr. Perry Hughes, Director of Workforce. Ms. Renee Thomas, Dean of Student Services. Mr. Jamie Edwards, Dean of Health and Occupational Programs. Unable to be with us today because he's actually somewhere representing WCC, Mr. Jacob Surratt, Dean of Transfer, Business, and Social Science. Mr. Sean McReynolds, Director of Technology. And last, And let me assure you, by no means, certainly not least, is Ms. Anita Burnett, my executive assistant. Please join me in acknowledging the success of the year. WCC is a place that truly lives its mission, vision, and saving values. For example, we live our college value of community partnerships with our schools, businesses and industries, economic development partners, and other community organizations to enrich and enhance the lives of our constituents. We're committed to the college value of building community and working together. This is evident in the collaboration within the leadership team, as well as with our partners in the Faculty Assembly, Support Staff Assembly, and Student Governance. In addition to the incredible leadership team, the dedicated faculty and staff, the great students, we're also fortunate to have a supportive board that helps guide the college, as well as the support of our education and scholarship foundations. I'm sure that you can see why I am humbled, honored, and above all, delighted to stand before you today as Wytheville Community College 7th President. Aside from my parents, who somehow were insightful enough to give me the academic name of Dean, few would have thought that I would be standing here today as a Community College President. The first thing that came to mind as I began thinking about today's event was the meaning of the word inauguration itself. Inauguration can be defined as an initiation, a commencement, or a beginning. Thought about how today's event formally symbolizes a new beginning for me and for Wytheville Community College and the communities that we serve. And for poor Chancellor Dubois having to deal with yet another North Carolina. But today is also about continuing journeys. It's a celebration of how we as individuals, organizations, communities continue to grow, change, develop, and evolve over time. For me personally, it caused me to reflect on where I come from as a first-generation college student, and how I came to be here today. It caused me to think about the individuals and the institutions and organizations and experiences, both positive and negative, that have influenced me. These certainly include family and friends, teachers, schools and colleges, mentors, co-workers, and just life in general. While there are many individuals who have been influential in my life, including many who are no longer with us, there are a few special people here today who I would like to acknowledge and recognize. My mother, of course, without whom I literally could not be standing. Thanks, Mom. Among other things, my mom modeled a strong work ethic and a respect for people no matter their station in life. That's a value that aligns perfectly with WCC's stated value of believing in the worth, dignity, and potential of all individuals. That's one of the things that attracted me to WCC. And there's my wife and best friend, Jane, who is truly my partner, supporter, and safe harbor in life. And without whom, again, quite literally, I would not be standing here before you today. My two sons, John and Nicholson, from whom I learned a completely new level of what it means to love and care for another human being. They are incredible people who, within this past year, have chosen incredible partners in life, and I look forward to the additional lessons in life that they will bring me and Jamie as John and Stephanie and Nick and Paige begin their lives together. I would also mention that these guys helped me learn some valuable lessons in patience, but we won't go there. And to my entire family, many of whom are here today, sisters, sister-in-law, brother-in-laws, nieces, nephews, aunts, uncles, and cousins, to all of you, I say thank you for helping me along the way. I'd also like to thank those of you here today who have become like family over the years, including those who are part of my Wilkes Community College family. If you're from Wilkes Community College, you stand. When I reflect upon my journey in learning about leadership, I would be remiss if I did not acknowledge the importance of a particular individual. Dr. Lloyd Burks, former president of Wilkes Community College, I learned so many lessons from Dr. Burns, including the value of collaboration, the importance of solid planning, treating people with dignity and respect, and much, much more. So thank you, Lloyd. There are, of course, many others here today who've had an influence on my path. And while too numerous to mention, just suffice it to say that I am extremely fortunate to have good friends, good colleagues, and family. And I'm appreciative of all of their contributions to making me who I am today. It's my goal and my hope that I can carry on that tradition of support and service to others that they have shared with me. So again, to all of you, I say thank you. Preparing for today's event also led me to think about the history of Wytheville Community College and all the community leaders, the faculty, the staff, and the students, and the history of the economy in the region. All of the things that have made WCC the great institution that it is today. The WCC we see today is a direct result of the hard work of past leadership, including past presidents, some of whom we're privileged to have with us here today. In many respects, we here today have been shaped by and are the linkage to the collective of all that has come before us. So what then is our charge? Just as those who came before us have enabled us to add value to our lives, our charge is to make ourselves, our college, and our communities stronger and better than we already are. We must continue to build and to add to a solid foundation for those who will come after us. And we're at an interesting juncture for community colleges. It's time for globalization, advances in technology, automation, a bachelor's robust mentality have greatly affected our workforce, particularly in our manufacturing sector. Here in Virginia, we're very fortunate at this moment in time to be enjoying unprecedented support for the community college's role in workforce development. We're here to address the skills and interest gaps of the workforce and to help our businesses and industries be economically competitive in a global market. Meeting this need will require both transfer and technical programs, but with a refined focus on the alignment of skills and workplace needs, as well as innovation in our programs and services. To meet this on the technical side, WCC is adding such offerings as mechatronics for advanced manufacturing and expanding our offerings in welding. We're partnering with other colleges to expand offerings such as collaborating with Southside Community College to offer alignment training, and partnering with other Southwest Virginia community colleges to expand our truck driver program. And while providing training for the technical skills for the workforce, we're simultaneously charged with providing education to enhance soft skills or employability skills, such as communication skills, professionalism, teamwork, problem solving. These skills were previously and oftentimes thought of as more relevant for general education courses or just for those transferring on to four-year degrees. And for those who are seeking to transfer to a four-year institution, we're providing professional development for our advisors, creating a guided pathways website that includes not only clear pathways to the degrees, diplomas, and certificates available through WCC, but also clear pathways to articulate to four-year institutions. We have a substantial number of dual enrollment students at our local high schools who we support through a dual enrollment coordinator and through student success coaches. And for our online learners, the college is improving online course quality through instructor certification for teaching online, and through skills assessment and support for our online learners, and through course reviews to ensure adherence to quality standards for online courses. Here at WCC, our ideal is that every student who comes to our college will leave with a degree or a credential, that they will leave with enhanced life and workplace skills, and with the knowledge and skills that will make them better people and better citizens. One of my favorite quotes is by Emerson. And Emerson said, "This time, like all times, is a very good one if we but know what to do with it." We know the challenge that lies before us. And while none of us can know with certainty what the future holds, in some ways, the pathway to knowing what to do is clear. At WCC, We must remain committed to the college's vision and mission. Our mission of providing access to lifelong learning within an environment of academic excellence. And all of us, faculty, staff, community, we must engage in lifelong learning. We must be learner and learning centered, focusing on access and student success. As an administration, we must engage in strategic planning to ensure that the personnel, facilities, and equipment are in place to serve our students and our employers in our businesses and industries. We must invest in professional development for our faculty and staff to ensure that we provide our students and the businesses and industries we serve with the highest quality of education, training, and services. And as a college, we must not only be a partner who responds to the needs of our community, but also serve as a leader for educational, workforce, and cultural growth and development for our community. That is what has brought us this far, and that is what we will continue to do to make a brighter future for those who come after us. I want to thank you all again for attending today's event. We're delighted that you're here. We hope that you will find the time to take a stroll down the hill and visit our beautiful campus. You too will see that WCC is indeed a special place that I am honored and delighted to be a part of. And I want to thank the faculty, staff, administration, and the community for the kindness and support that Jamie and I have received over this past year. And I want to thank the WCC Board and Chancellor DuBois for the opportunity to serve with the Community College and the Virginia Community College system. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Sprinkle. It has become tradition to place a portrait of each WCC president in the college's library. As part of today's ceremony, we are pleased to present the formal portrait of Dr. Sprinkle. Mr. Thompson, the Chancellor of Wild will assist. WCC has had the good fortune to have many outstanding presidential leaders during its past 53 years. We actually were formed a little bit as a branch of Virginia Tech prior to the community college system. And those include those that you've met today, Dr. Bill Snyder, Dr. Ed Lawrence, and Dr. Charlie Waddy. I had the privilege to work with each of these presidents, and they left large shoes to fill. When Charlie White announced his intentions to retire, I think that it's safe to say that the entire campus community was somewhat nervous. However, the day I met Dr. Sprinkle, I immediately sensed that he was an outstanding leader. After his interview and presentation, I was confident that he was the best person to be our next president. During his first year in that role, he has definitely confirmed that my initial impression was correct. Not only has he helped lead WCC through a successful reaccreditation process, but he's also been instrumental in helping expand workforce programs, exploring new curricular program opportunities, and developing a tenure facilities master plan. He and his wife, Jamie, have also devoted a great deal of time to meeting people throughout the college's service region, and they are both involved in numerous volunteer community projects. I would be remiss if I didn't mention that he has quickly become involved with the WCC Educational Foundation and the WCC Scholarship Foundation. During the past year, private donations, pledges, and grant funds have totaled over $1.5 million. From my perspective, Dr. Sprinkle, you are definitely a keeper. I can think of only one time since you arrived that I had a moment of concern about a decision that you made. That involved the President's Cabinet retreat. When you announced the idea of a retreat, the other members of the leadership team and I thought it was a great idea. We envisioned a couple of days at a nice conference hotel where we could focus on developing a new college-wide strategic plan. Now, please understand, we didn't expect to go to the homestead or the Greenbrier. However, I must admit that a summer youth camp along the New River in the dead of winter with lodging accommodations that included bunk beds and shared restrooms wasn't exactly what we had imagined. Dr. DeBlanc, I can assure you that you will never have to worry about Dr. Sprinkle's use of state resources. In the end, though, Dr. Sprinkle, your selection of that particular retreat location ultimately reinforced our confidence in your leadership style. After all, with limited cell phone service and almost non-existent amenities, we really had no choice except to focus on the task at hand. Joking aside, Dr. Sprinkle has already accomplished a great deal. To echo what others have shared today, Dr. Sprinkle is an extraordinary leader who is truly committed to WCC's mission and the students and communities that we serve. Dr. Sprinkle, thank you for choosing WCC and for serving as our president. Congratulations and best wishes. Thank all of you for joining us this afternoon to celebrate the beginning of this new chapter in the history of the college and in expressing our support of Dr. Sprinkle and his leadership. Following the academic processional, you are cordially invited to join us for a reception honoring Dr. Sprinkle. We are pleased to have Brenda Whitworth, classical pianist from Wytheville, who will continue sharing her talents with us. We sincerely hope everyone will stay and enjoy the reception. Will those in the academic processional please rise?